Let's welcome to the show someone who knows all about Hawaii because she was on Big Break Ka'anapali in 2008. She turned professional in 1987, LPGA teaching professional, 26 professional wins, all-time career money leader on the Futures Tour. Yes, indeed. And she is going to tell us about Yar Golf. It's Yar. Lori Atsedes, welcome to the show.
Well, hello, Danielle. Thanks for having me.
It's my pleasure. First, got to ask you, how did you hook up with Yar Golf?
Well, it's a funny story. Just like many professionals, we're always searching for some magic bean or pill or the secret to golf. I was at a pro-am in Arizona, and I saw this really tall lady with red hair, and I saw these strange-looking putters, and I thought, another gimmick, but I was inquisitive enough to go over and pick one up, and I hit two or three putts with it, and I thought, what's different? There's something really different about this, and that's really how it started. I felt something different. It was unusual to me. It was obvious, looks a little different for a lot of reasons, but what I was really experiencing was, you know, what the bones of the putter were about, what the science and the technology, because nothing I've ever tried felt like it.
Yeah, the putter, let me just backtrack a little bit. It's designed by an aeronautical physicist, an aerospace engineer designer.
Yes, Dr. Vanderbilt, not even a golfer, but a very more intelligent person than I think I've ever met in my life. And she met a lady named Jerry at a wedding she was attending. And I guess Jerry was upset because she had a bad day of putting. And I guess in her ball gown, getting ready for a wedding, thought she might be able to help this lady with a putter. So she designed her a putter, and that's how it started. It's a pretty cool story.
Yeah, that's Dr. V. I mean, just gets right in there. I'm going to fix this. Can you explain? Now, see, when I talk to her, I get confused because she is talking in a language that most of us don't understand.
Yeah, you know, she does have bigger words than I've ever been used to hearing and using, but the more I've been around her, the more I understand. But the way I look at it and the way I simplify it for everybody, because I'm a player, is that it's an instrument that I've been given to use that's as perfect can be, meaning it's balanced in any direction you swing it. The club face doesn't twist or turn. You don't really have to be in control of it as much as the conventional putters. And that's the lifelong search of a golfer, is how to control your putter. Who can control your putter the best wins the golf tournament. It all comes down to putting. You know, whoever has that feel, that rhythm, that timing that matches the putter they're using wins the golf tournament, but they don't win every week for a reason. They don't have that same ability every week because there's human factor involved. So if we give somebody like Aaron Badley took our putter and he was 14th on the putting list and he used it for 6 weeks, he used it in competition and he climbed all the way up to second on the list of putting stats. So what that says to me is there's a guy who knows he's a good putter but doesn't perform every week with a normal conventional putter, but with our putter and the instruction or guidance, the putter led him to move up the putting stats. What that tells us is just the equipment was so much better that he got better at putting. But just like everybody else, money is the big lure in golf, and when you get paid a lot of money to use other equipment, they end up switching because, you know, they don't recognize that being a better putter makes you more money. It's not always about taking the money before the equipment.
Yeah, well, that's one of the problems that small companies have, period. End of story. You know, you come out with a great idea, it really, really works, but if you don't have the marketing money behind you, it's very difficult to get your product out. In the meantime, we will talk about Yar putters. They look strange to people.
Well, they look the way they do for Dr. V's reason for meeting president of the company, Jerry. Jerry had a bad hip and couldn't bend over to comfortably get the ball off the ground or out of the cup. So it looks that way because it fits inside the cup and can actually pick the ball up. And it also marks the ball and originally designed also can fix a ball mark with the attached divot tool, which, I mean, is ingenious in itself. So it looks that way for our reasons. We're not going to change the design because we think it's perfect. Its utility utilitarian. It serves a lot of practical purposes.
Wow.
So that's really how that design came about.
Okay, so in other words, if there's someone who has a real difficult time bending over to get the ball out of the cup once they've made the putt, you can take that club and pick up without bending over?
Without bending over, it fits inside the golf hole, doesn't damage the edges, lifts the ball right up out of the cup. If you look on the website, the video of Aaron Baddeley using it on tour, he sticks the ball in the hole in the putter and hands it to his caddy. It was just kind of a cool visual of how the putter actually does hold the ball.
Wow. That's yargolf.com. Yar Golf. And Yar is a great word. I love the word. Yar is a description. She's Yar. That's a boat, a sailboat, a ship, whatever. It describes something that's in perfect working order, seaworthy, and sails perfectly. Yar. Look up the word. It's Y-A-R. It's a great word. I love it. It's from a movie. You know what one I'm talking about. Now, this is from golftestusa.com. We have found the Yar putter has shown through both public domain testing, which we post the results on our website for all the golfing public to view, and proprietary tests, that it is a putter that should be considered by all golfers looking to improve their putting. Golf Test USA does not receive any compensation from the Yar putter company or advertising revenue from any company in the golf industry. Our only goal in providing information of this type is to assist golfers in making informed decisions about which golf equipment they should consider using to improve their game. I thought that was quite a compliment.
Yeah, just knowing that all the technology has the same science and just coming to understand that even the people who design putters don't even understand the science. They have to sell putters and they have to sell golf equipment. So they come up with a marketing gimmick. Everybody's got one. But we're not a gimmick. It's truly a putter, and I like to call it an instrument because it's not like everything else. It's perfect. It's pure. You can putt in any direction with it. You can putt with one hand. It's really designed to be used in a one-handed mode. If you can imagine someone, a couple soldiers have come back, wounded warriors, and they're left with one arm. And we've given them a putter that is absolutely functional for only having one hand or one arm. So it's a pretty unique, the science is unique. I believe as a player that in the future you'll see the science in all golf clubs. In 2012, somebody can stabilize an iron by 45% by changing the science. That's a pretty big deal with the golf business.
It's not magic, it's physics.
It's not magic, it's physics. It's pretty special.
Okay, now fitting is an integral part of buying a club. Now, we're in Hawaii, and I want to go to yargolf.com, and it says order. But I want to fit it to me. I want it to be my length. Can I do that online?
Yeah, we really don't want our putters in a golf shop where you can just go in and buy one, and maybe it fits you and maybe it doesn't. We really want this to be the last putter you ever have to buy. So we've made a fitting video, and it's very simple. You really only need a golf club, a ruler, and a piece of tape, and we need three numbers. And the video walks you through the whole process. You can do it in your home, you can do it outside, you can do it anywhere, not golf course. You don't have to do it on the golf course.
Mm-hmm.
So you can do it at home, take about 5 minutes. Made it pretty simple to watch the video and understand it, and we're always here for any questions that people have, and we've had a few over the last few months. So we've made the video as good as we can for the everyday golfer at home.
Great. Now, you say you only want people to buy one putter and have it for the rest of their life. That's why you have the GX1 putter assurance policy?
Yep, we do have the assurance policy that if anything needed repair or replacing, that policy covers it. We believe that the face should wear out in the golf club, but to date, nobody has a face that you can take on and take off and replace. You have to get a whole new putter. So Dr. Vanderbilt has really carefully examined all the areas of the golf club and has made them really golf-specific, and so that it can be replaced, it can be fixed, and it should be, because it will wear out.
Yeah, okay. Well, see, and you can get the assurance policy. You send it in for servicing. They take care of it. Send it back. There you go. Your putter's ready.
We like to think of it as an airplane, right? The airplane needs a little servicing every once in a while because this is all done off of aeronautic science, and it's a well-balanced machine, and it's going to need some maintenance over the years.
I love your description. We have to take a break. Thank our sponsors who make this show possible. Can you stay with me?
Yes.
Thank you. We'll be back right after this. My name is Danielle Tucker. This is The Golf Club.
Let's get back into the clubhouse with Danielle Tucker.
Welcome back. We're talking with Lori Atsedes. Did you enjoy being on Maui when you were in big break on the Pali?
You know, I've always enjoyed Hawaii. When I was on the LPGA, we spent a lot of time out there playing, and it was just a really unique opportunity for me to get out of my hometown and visit someplace beautiful. And Kahanapali, I mean, Ed, director of golf there, is just the greatest guy, and they have the greatest staff, and I love the golf course, and we got to stay at the Sheraton Maui right across the street, and we had beautiful rooms, and it was just a really great trip for most of us anyways. We spent 19 days there filming.
19 days? Tell me, you know, I was talking to LPGA Director of Communication, Mike Scanlon, a couple minutes ago, and we were talking about how they choose the Olympic team. Maybe we should do it like Big Break, you know, break glass. But is how much is there serious competition in Big Break, and how much of the tension that they create on television, you know, the tension, how much is it real?
Well, you know, everybody always asks me, the first question is it scripted? The reason they don't have to script it is what the viewers forget is that we're there 19 days in a row, and you're on camera and mic from 6 a.m. to midnight. And if you have a problem with somebody on a Monday, that problem doesn't go away Tuesday morning. So the tensions rise and the battles are, you know, heated because it's every day, all day. And you only get to see one episode a week. So you think, oh, we should have gotten over it by now. But we don't get over it because it happens so soon, as in the day or the day before an episode. So the tension and the drama, it you would think it would have to be scripted, but it just works out that it doesn't need to be. And it's kind of fun that way, too, because you never know what you're going to get.
No, you mean to tell me you're mic'd from what time to what time? Say that again.
6 a.m. Let's see. On Kahanapali, you get up and they put the mic on you at 6 a.m. And by the time you finish doing interviews and everything for the evening, you could be done at midnight.
Wow. Well, that's
nonstop.
Yeah, that's tension right there.
Well, that's just it. You're so exhausted by 4 or 5 days into it that, you know, if something happens and you got an issue with somebody, it becomes a big deal.
I bet. You're playing on the LPGA Senior Tour sometimes, aren't you?
Yeah, I play the Legends Tour, and I joined the LPGA Teaching Division a couple years ago. Just before my last big break in the Dominican, I was hit by a drunk driver.
Oh.
And since then, I've only played part-time. I've been a little hard physically to play full-time. And, you know, it's also a hard game to lay down, and sometimes you get a little wake-up call and you think, well, is golf really where I'm supposed to be? And I say yes, but maybe not on tour. So I've enjoyed playing part-time, and I enjoy still helping tour players with their game, and I've really found a lot of reward in teaching now full-time.
Where do you teach?
I live in Phoenix, Arizona, and I teach in Goodyear, Arizona at Tres Rios at Estrella Mountain. And it's just been phenomenal. The big break kind of launched a little bit of my teaching career, because everywhere I go, everybody kind of recognized me. So when they found out I was teaching, they thought they better get a lesson from Big Break Lori.
Big Break Lori. You got a nickname.
Well, I was my friend in Kahanapali. I don't know if I can say it on air, but my nickname was BBB. the Big Break B, you know. And then the second big break, everybody calls me up and says, "We didn't know you were that nice." I'm like, "Are you kidding me? I'm a nice person."
but I mic'd from 6 a.m. to midnight. What do you expect?
They needed a bad guy for the first one because the girls were too nice.
Oh, voila. Yes. Yes, there is a script going on, but it's, you know, it's great. It's don't you think it helps people, some people, launch their career?
Yeah, it's, you know, just like anything else. A good round can launch your career, and a bad round can derail your career. So a lot of careers have been launched. You know, you have Tommy Two Gloves, Jamie.
Mm-hmm.
You have Christy McPherson, who went on to, you know, be pretty successful on the LPGA. And then you have players who quit golf altogether because the pressure was a little too much for them and they may not have been ready for it. And, you know, so it's done both. But ultimately, it's a golf show. It should be entertainment. And sometimes we take things too seriously for our own good, and we kind of get in the way of remembering the joy in things.
You know, and that's the lesson to be learned this morning, children. Don't forget the joy in things.
Yeah. There's so many valleys in golf that when you're on the peak, we forget to enjoy it.
Yeah.
And you're going to fall down that peak quicker than you're going to get to the top of it.
Well, Yar Golf, we've just about run out of time. And I just want to remind people that the putter, I have one, and it really is something. Yar
Can
Golf.
Can I say that the reason I didn't succeed on tour to the level that I thought I could was because my belief in my putting wasn't as strong as my belief in my ball striking. And what Yar has done is bridge that gap. It has given me an instrument that matches my belief. And my belief is that I've always been a better putter, but I've never had the equipment that allowed me to be a better putter. And that's the biggest difference in the science and in the putter.
Wow. I'd like to put it in Michelle Wee's hands.
Well, I'd like to put it in a lot of people's hands.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks so much for being on the show. It's been a pleasure
Thank
meeting you.
You.
Absolutely. It's been my pleasure.